Wir are. Viva Dia e Viva! Thank you so much to Jebaus. Suasigdastan. Dunkignit. Wow! Ik wil gewoon wow backwards say. Wow! So we are in for an amazing time. Next on our program is a lady that has shown that she's capable of taking the message of the DA from Cape Town to KwaZulu-Natal all the way to the Eastern Cape. She's our national spokesperson, and we are delighted that she's here with us today. Democrats, we need to give her a round of applause as we welcome the DA's national spokesperson, Siviwe, Gwarube!
Cape Town. So, see, I vote on Gwarube and we're voting the DA for you and not the other way around. And that is his commitment to you. So viva DA, viva! Viva DA, viva!
Amandla! Are you still excited? I remember growing up and I couldn't even read or write. You know the sign if you leave a building, it says excite. Explain to someone there at the back. But I'm excited because come Tuesday, the incoming mayor-elect GHL, Geordin Lewis, will be our elected mayor. That's exciting news. That's exciting news. Because we need to give a stern message to other parties that they need to exit. If they want to go to other provinces and do whatever they want to do, we are coming because as a DA, we know that we can do more. Ikapa ilisi benza. So we know Kapstad werk. On that note, let's keep the energy. Welcome our provincial leader. He's the MEC for Community Safety, a fighter, a dedicated servant of the people.
Say salam alaikum. Salaam salam. Tong, I just want to say, John, a very warm welcome to the Western Cape and to Cape Town. And I want to say one thing today on record for the whole nation to hear. I want to make this point because when you switch the TV on, you really think this party is a divided party. You have united this party, John. Viva, John, viva. Never been so united. The spirit has never been so high as now in this election. And that's the reason why we're going to get in this metro more than 60%, I say so. Wallahi Qasam, we're going to get more than 60%. I want to acknowledge Dan Plato. I really want to say to Dan, thank you, Dan, and really acknowledge you for the work that you have done. And that. Yes. Right. Thank you. Dan. All the other public reps with you, with your team, that whole team, and all those people, I want to also say thank you to all our councillors who are leaving now, who found the time to say, listen, I'm not exiting, not because I have a problem, in fact, they're the main campaigners, but because my time has not come to exit, because in this party, we know when to come and when to go. So, as gaan retire, so thank you, Dan, thanks to that team. Thank you to everyone in that team. I want to say also to the whole provincial executive, I want to acknowledge them this morning here. And I want to acknowledge all our members of the provincial executive. And to say to you, thank you for the guys and for the nights that we sat late. When you know something that there's no more smoke in the room, but it's just like there are a lot of COVID pentacles going. So I'm saying thank you to the PEC. To our Metro exec, I want to say thank you. And in the Metro exec, I want to specifically say to one person, you know, Benedicta van Minden, I want to say thank you to you for the work and for driving this campaign in the metro. I really want to say that and acknowledge you. I also bring warm greetings from the East region and from the West region to this metro region. And they're wishing you well with this, you know, this rally today. And they're wishing you well with our last few days where we're going to fetch every single person out of every house to come and to vote for the DA so that we can win this metro. And I couldn't help it, Democrats. I couldn't help it. When I see, as I drove here, and you know, as you drive, you see these little skew posters, and some posters, they stole our posters to put their posters on. Hulle het geld om 'n poster op te sit. Hoe gaan hulle govern? How are they going to govern? En dan sien jy een gesiggie, en dan nog 'n gesiggie, en die een gesiggie kan nie alleen staan, maar hy sê wat jy, hy moet 'n wit gesiggie by die ander gesiggie wees. So hy kan nie alleen staan, maar hy sê wat jy. That's what they want on those parties. So what I want to say to those parties, and I won't mention one of them by name. You know why? Because I won't give them any free time, any air time. I want to say to them, gaan skarrel aan 'n plek. Julle is soos rotte wat skarrel op die krummels. So gaan skarrel aan 'n plek. Nee, hier nie. Hier is die DA blauw. Hier is die provincie blauw. As ons dit in Afrikaans sê, dis die enigste manier hoe hulle verstaan. Ons kan dit net in Afrikaans sê. Vra my Brent Heron, hy het geweet wat ek sê, hy kom 'n skarrelkat noem my. Hy's 'n skarrelkat. The last point I want to make around die skarrelkatte en die klein parties is, yo, you know, I listened to a radio interview yesterday, and then the poor survey person who's now giving back, the analyst, he said that the Cape Metro was far ahead of every other metro. He said that in service delivery, in water, in everything. And of course, as Siviwe said, we must do far more. But he said in this city, everyone, whether you're from Kailicha or Constantia, Hanover Park or Delft, Osdenayo, or whether you're from wherever you are, whatever squatter camp you are, you have clean water. You don't drink mud water. You don't drink water that makes you sick. And yes, we are going to work. And I spoke to the mayor-elect. You know, we had a very long meeting where he said we need to develop an incredible plan for all our areas of, and we can't help it, colleagues. I'm not talking as the Western Cape. We can't help it if you're the best. Everyone comes here. We're the best. So everyone comes to us. We can't help it. And that is a democratic right of everyone to come wherever it is the better and better for them. So we will not stop people from, they will come. We will try and make it better for people to live, and we're going to make it better. And I want to also say, colleagues, the time has now really come. Now, this is also for the record, campaign manager Van Manen, just for the record, in the metro, the ANC is irrelevant. They're irrelevant. In smaller towns, yes, they have a little bit of So in smaller towns, yes, they still, and our guys are working hard in the East and West region. But I want to say the time has come to finally switch the lights off of the ANC. It's time to switch the lights off. They switch the lights off on us. We're in darkness. Our kids must write exam in darkness. Our houses have been burgled for this couple of few days all over. I'm in security, so I know. Stop the ANC, switch off their damn lights. And it's a joke. How do you vote for a party who can't keep the lights on? They are bloody junk. That's what they are. Finally, ladies and gentlemen, finally, Democrats. I will, as the leader of the Democratic Alliance in this province, I will make one fundamental mistake. Let me repeat that. I will make one fundamental mistake if I don't today say to every single activist who's sitting here today, if I don't say to you, Thank you, thank you, thank you. If I don't say to you today, buy a donkey, buy a donkey, buy a donkey. If I don't say to every single activist here today, shukran, shukran, shukran. If I don't say to every public rep, to every councillor here, to every leadership member, members of the executive, all the leadership, thank you, college. We are busy doing it. We have done it. We are going to do better. On Monday, we're going to show what the culmination of hard work is, not only the election forever. So I want to say to everyone, thank you, thank you, thank you, colleagues. Thank you very much.
Viva DA, viva!
Viva! Amandla! Down with the ANC, down! Gone with the small parties, gone! The electricity on! Viva DA, viva!
Our Minister Albert Fritz, give him another round of applause. Democrats, we are in for an amazing final part of our program here. But if I announce the next person, this roof must basically lift. He was born and raised in KZN. He's been leading our party. He's the captain of our ship. We know that during a difficult time, he stood up and said he is available. So let us honor and applaud our leader for the stance that he has taken. We are here to celebrate, and we are going to secure victory. So ladies and gentlemen, as we stand, and you see that we are the most diverse party in the entire South Africa, please welcome Mr. John Steenhuisen! Yes! Viva! Viva John! Viva John!
Klim op die wa, klim op die wa, klim op die dia se wa.
He said no.
Klim op die dia se wa. Wakker bikkie, wakker bikkie. Klim op die bus, klim op die bus, klim op GHL se bus.
Yeah, yeah.
Klim op die bus, klim op die bus. Klim op GHL se bus. Daar sê hy. Jo, jo, jo. Ek kan sê die mense hier is baie duidelik vandag, né? Is ons gereed vir die 1 November? Is ons gereed vir 'n wen? Is ons gereed om dit die stadsaal te stap en vir die mense te sê, ons is terug? Is ons gereed vir 'n burgemeester met die naam van Geordin? Jo, ek kan nie wag. Dis warm hier vandag, maar op die 1 November sal heel wat warmer daar wees. Want dan skop ons die bendes uit. Ons skop die misdaders uit. Ons skop werkloosheid uit. Ons skop hierdie ander klein partye uit. En ons sal daar staan en sê, dis ons span, dis die blou span, dis my span, dis jou span. But you know this election I've seen some funny things. Yo, there's some funny things happening in the country. It's only in South Africa where you can be in stage 4 load shedding. Stage 4 load shedding. The lights are off. The factories are off, The businesses are off and our children's futures are being turned off. But I opened the newspaper and I saw Rama promises up in Durban. And you weet wat hy gedoen het? He was launching an electric car. An electric car in stage 4 load shedding. My magtig mense, dis belaglik. Hy kan nie eers die ligte aanhou en nou wat sê jy moet 'n elektriese motor hê. Hierdie regering het die televisie is hier, sy kan nie sê wat ek word. Hulle het geen idee om hierdie land te regeer. Hulle het geen idee om dinge reg te maak in hierdie land. Daar's net een party dat dit kan doen. Dis ons party, dis die DA wat ons kry dinge gedoen. And I'm very proud to be here today because today is not just about, you know, what we've been doing. It's about a record of action and a promise of, oh, more. I thought you'd be more excited about the more. The more's going to keep the lights on. The more's going to create jobs. The more's going to fix the potholes. The more's going to make sure that we've got water in our communities. A record of action and a promise of more. Exactly right. Exactly right. And the reality is, Cape Town works because the DA works for you. That's why Cape Town works. Now, Cape Town doesn't sit back and say, oh, we're happy to be the best run municipality, metro in the country. We're happy to be the top of ratings Africa. We're happy to have the cleanest audit, the only metro in the country. Oh, we sit back, we're happy. Is that what the DA does? No. The DA says, we've done a lot, we're going to do more. We don't want to be measured by South African standards. We want to be measured by world standards. We want Cape Town to be a world-class city with trains that run on time, with buses that get people to work, with social housing so we can give our people opportunities closer to the cities. That's the Cape Town we want, and we're never going to stop. We're never going to stop and say, ons is gelukkig. Daar's altyd meer om te doen. En ons staan gereed om meer te doen hier in hierdie stad. Now look, how much is Monday is about Cape Town and its potential and the potential that the DA has. It's also about keeping out a party that leaves destruction in its wake. Nou mense, ek was rondom die land in hierdie verkiesing. Ek het in elke provinsie gewees. Ek was in klein dorpies, ek was in stede rondom die land. And everything the ANC has touched in South Africa has turned to corruption. Everything they touch. Everything they touch turns to cadre deployment. Everything they turn to touch turns to unemployment. You can't trust the ANC. And I've been in municipality after municipality after municipality. Waar die reels in die strate. Die mense sit vir dae sonder krag. The people go without electricity for days on end. Not because of load shedding, but because the municipality hasn't paid the bills or it hasn't spent the money on the infrastructure to keep the lights on. You're going to wake up in South Africa in one of two scenarios. A DA-run municipality or an ANC-run municipality. What municipality do you want to wake up in? I can't hear you. Yeah, that's it. There are only two types of ANC government. Ones that have failed and ones that are about to fail. That is the reality. They don't have a good story to tell. And we must keep their hands off Cape Town because I promise you, if they get their hands on Cape Town, it's going to end up like every other metro in this country that they've ruined. Ho, hulle, uit. And we're not just happy to sit back. Geordin Hill-Lewis and his team have imagined a Cape Town where the residents and the local economy are insulated and protected from the rampokkers and benders that sit there in Pretoria. They're going to protect you because they have failed. Because he's built a plan for the city, and you can't see it. Dis nou 'n man met 'n plan en ek hou van 'n man wat sy man en sy plan kan staan. And that plan isn't about something that's going to happen maybe sometime in the future. Look far into die toekoms. Those things are happening already. They've started already. He's not even in government yet, and he started delivering already. And that is the difference. Cape Town is already leading the way with LEAP officers to keep communities safe. Cape Town is already keeping people insulated from the worst failures of national government. Because we've got a duty to protect our citizens from the failures of national government. Our duty is not to Pretoria. Our duty is not to Ramaphosa. Our duty is not to the ANC. Our duty is to you, the residents of Cape Town, who have voted us in to get things done. We can't just sit back and say, oh, well, the trains don't work. We can't just say that. Ons mense moet by die werk uitkom. And that's why we're going to get in there. We're going to take over the trains. We're going to make sure that people can get to work safely and cheaply in a DA-run municipality. And we're going to fight for control of Metro Rail. And it's a fight that with your help, we can win. But until we get Capetonians back onto the Metro Rail, just to show you, dis nie 'n regering wat slaap nie. And Premier Windy and your team at Province, and ons is vreeslik trots op ons premier, né? Stand up, Premier. Dis nou 'n premier. Didn't sit back and say, well, you know, we're not in control of the trains, so people must just take their chances. During the COVID, he piloted the Red Dot taxi system, partnering with the taxi industry in a world-class development. But after that stopped, he's now introduced the Blue Dot system, which is going to keep people safe on taxis. It's exactly the innovation and public-private partnership and a partnership that's going to keep people moving in the city, to keep people getting to work, to keep people getting home safely. But perhaps the best example of us shielding people from the ANC is what we were able to do around electricity. You can't build an economy, you can't build a country, you can't build a business, you cannot build a family without basics like electricity. En dis 'n skande dat ons matriculants moet sit in 'n huis met 'n kersie om te leer vir hulle finale eksamens. Dis 'n skande. Hoe kan dit wees in 'n land soos Suid-Afrika dat mense sit rondom kersies elke nag? ANC, another night with candles. Now, and I just want to show you the difference between these two parties. The two differences between these two. I call it the tale of two cities. So there were two announcements this week when the country moved to stage four load shedding. The one announcement was from a city in Johannesburg, where the mayor came out, ANC mayor came out and said, oh, we're not accepting the load shedding. We're not going to switch the lights off. We're not moving it. A day later, the city of Cape Town came out and said, we're going to shield the residents of Cape Town. We're going to make sure that when there's load shedding stage four, they load shed at one stage behind the rest of the country. One was true, and one was a blatant election lie. A lie. Which one do you think was telling the truth? Who? The DA was telling the truth. Because that Joburg mayor had to slink back into his office like this and say, Yama datek leef, I can't keep the lights on, Yama eskom. But what has City of Cape Town done? It's protected all of its residents from one load shedding, and in some stages this week, from two levels of load shedding. So while the lights were off in the rest of the country, the DA kept the lights on here in Cape Town. Now, which party would you trust with your vote in this election? Yeah. Absolutely. Because when we say we're going to get things done, we get things done. So your choice is simple in this election. En jy sal sien daai stembrief. Ek dink in hierdie stad hy sal so lank wees. Met al hierdie klein boksenbende partye daaroor. En jy kan sien hulle, dat's die vriende, familie plus ANC retreat. Dat's the Polsmore Alliance daaroor ook. Maar hierdie partye, hulle sal jou stem vat en vry met die ANC na die verkiesing. Hulle is soos a one night stand. It's a one night stand. When you wake up in the morning after the election, they've gone, they've taken your cell phone and your wallet and everything that was in your kitchen. That's what they do because they don't care about you. You need a party that's going to stand with you and stand strong for the next 5 years. You need a party you can trust, a party that's going to get things done for you for the next 5 years. So, I'm here to tell you that our country is in a dangerous, dangerous place. We're in a precarious position with a national government that cannot even do the basics anymore. Water, electricity, sanitation are basics. They cannot get it right. So now's not the time for you to waste your vote on some party based around some personality or a race or a language or a culture. Now's not the time to watch the media and our opponents try and make this election about anything else other than service delivery. They're trying to make it about anything else other than service delivery. Now's not the time to try something new and untested. So, on Monday, we're going to give our opponents here in the city of Cape Town a snot club. A snot club of note that they're not going to forget for the next 5 years. Ek wou 'n ander klap noem, maar my ma is hier vandag. So on Monday, let's go out and secure this country's future and this city's future for another 5 years. On Monday, let's get out there and protect the incredible progress Cape Town has already made and then do even more. On Monday, let's go out and vote for Cape Town's place, not only at the top of the pile in South Africa, but on the top of the pile of the world. This means voting for die enigste party wat kry dinge gedoen, die enigste burgemeester wat sal dinge gedoen kry, Geordin Hill-Lewis, hou by die blou, stem by die blou, hou by die blou, stem by die blou, hou by die blou, stem by die blou, hou by die blou, stem.
So right now we're literally in the center of Cape Town in a community called Bonteville. We are about 85,000 people that live in this area. Bonteville had a very, very high murder rate. Because of our lack of policing in the area, on a daily basis we were losing people to gang violence.
We were infected and inflicted with gang violence.
Our kids couldn't even play in peace in the park. I was actually very scared even to leave my home. Constantly, I will say constantly living in fear.
For a city or a government to be effective in fighting crime, you need around one police officer for every 220 members of the public. At the moment, Cape Town, in terms of SAPS resources, is sitting around one to every 560. The LEAP program by the city and the province is an attempt to compensate for those very low SAPS deployment figures in those areas where it matters most. In the 10 most affected crime hotspots, we are deploying 100 officers each with the goal of halving the murder rate, seriously improving the safety, and thereby allowing investment, job creation, and the normalization of community life in those areas.
LEAP's brought about high levels of law enforcement visibility in the area. Where there was no visibility, we now have visibility at key times.
Before we had this program, there were days when I dreaded even getting up. But afterwards, I felt safe because, you know, I could be walking down the street or crossing the road or down Bonteville Avenue, and I would see 5 law enforcement vehicles in that time just passing me by, which made me feel safer.
What we need to do here is be visible, to patrol, to build relationships with communities, to act on tip-offs, to be responsive, to attend to hotspots.
We set up street WhatsApp groups in every single street of this community. So whenever there were issues, whenever things went wrong, whenever there was a problem, we were able to immediately report these issues through.
Look where we're standing today. We're standing here. We walked all the way from the center. We weren't robbed. We weren't accosted. Nothing happened to us. Here's young people out, here's old people out. We joggers passed us.
So LEAP is not just about 100 law enforcement officers coming to an area. LEAP is about bringing communities together. LEAP's about building relationships where relationships were broken before.
None of this would have been possible if it hadn't been for LEAP and the law enforcement officers.
So we need to see more local community leaders engaging the program, understanding the program, and being able to communicate with community and the officers to ensure that the programs actually become successful.
This afternoon, Democrats is nog steeds more. We are in for our final speech here this afternoon. It is my honor to introduce our mayoral candidate, a man that has been active in politics for more than 17 years. In 2007, when the former mayor of Cape Town, Helen Zille, was arrested in Mitchells Plain because he participated in an anti-drug march, Geordin was there. He's been working in the National Assembly as our Shadow Minister for Finance. He was Chief of Staff in the Office of the DA Leader. His track record in Parliament within the DA speaks of excellence. But more than that, Democrats, his characteristics is clear. He's worked in some of our areas across Nyanga and Guguletu. He doesn't need to put on his GPS if he goes to Guguletu. Hy sit hy sy GPS aan as hy in die middel van die nag in Nyanga ry nie. He's been working there. 5 years ago, I went through a difficult time, and I think I must share this, Geordin. I went through a difficult time and I lost my mom. En as jou ma afsterf, is dit nie lekker nie. En ons doen die planning en Geordin skakel. En ek sê waar die funeral gaan wees en Geordin stiek uit. Hy stiek uit. Hy support. Hy is by die funeral. Hy praat met mense daar asof hy daar behoort. Van die behoort daar. En hy het ook die GPS, hy het Rocklands Beaches Plan toe gery, sonder GPS. So we know his characteristics, his track record speak of excellence. We are in for an amazing new season under our mayor-elect. So ladies and gentlemen, stand with me as we commence a chant, G-H-L. 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 It is my honor, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Geordin Hill Lewis! G-H-L! 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 G-H-L!
Vegan, we're dancing up! Hello, Yala! Yes, see, dis warm hier vandag, né? Die vonke spat. Ons is so geëerd. We are honored to have heard the speeches that we've heard here today. From our national leader, John Steenhuisen. An amazing speech. Thank you, John. It's an honor to have you here. John is extremely busy. Hy's 'n baie besige man. Hy's oral sy land. Maar hy's hier met ons vandag, né? Ons is geëerd. All of our speeches, Bev and Dan, Mayenne, Bertie, die vonke het gespat, ne? Hier was Bertie warm vandag. You know what makes me so proud today? We talk about the blue machine. We talk about the blue golf. But actually it's a blue family. It's a blue family. Usapo. Is that the right word? Usapo? Yes, I thought so. And seeing you here today warms my heart so much. Because everything that we do as a blue family is to improve the lives of people in our city. And that's what you've heard through all of our speeches today. It's not about being number one. Gaan nie net oor nommer 1 te wees in die land. Ons weet ons is nommer 1. Ons is kop en skouers bo almal. But it's about the difference that we are making in your communities. That's why I love that we started with the song, because you are simply the best. You are simply the best. I'm also so proud that my wife is with me today. I see that most of the time she was sitting next to Bertie. Bertie, ek check for jou, ne? Ek kookeloer, Bertie. Ek check for jou. Regan het gesê, hallelujah, ek loeja. It's so great to be here for the last event of our campaign. What a great campaign it's been. Thank you to each and every one of our activists, our canvassers, our candidates, our campaign team under Benedicta and her team. You have done an amazing job for 3 months and even before that, and over the last 2 months in particular, I've seen every single one of you, the work that you've done. Hard yards. Dis hoekom ons gaan wen. Ons het die hardste gewerk. We take it personally. We take it personally. This is about improving people's lives. This is our family. This is blou familie, né? So as iemand ons familie aanval, val hulle vir ons aan. Dit werk mos so, né? Jy kan jou moeder kritiseer, maar niemand anders nie. Dis ons familie. And it's been wonderful to see our family out there. Monday, the 1st of November, is going to be an historic day for Cape Town. Ons pragtige moederstad. On that day, the people of Cape Town have got an opportunity to start writing the new chapter for our city. The next chapter is going to be about securing the future of each and every one of our families, neighborhoods, and communities in this beautiful city. Dis 'n storie oor hoe Kaapstad 'n lighuis, 'n baken van hoop is in ons land. Wat wys, ons hoef nie om net die agteruitgang in ons land te aanvaar nie. Ons kan opstaan as gemeenskappe en iets doen. En die enigste party wat kan iets doen, is die party wat dinge gedoen kry. En dis die DA. That we, the people of Cape Town, have the power to fix this city. Cape Town has an incredible story. That's why we love the city. Daar was stories van verval en baie laagpunte in ons geskiedenis. Ons weet daarvan. Ons onthou daai goed, né? En daar's ook stories van ongelooflike oorwinnings. Maar bo alles, dit is 'n storie van 'n stad wat net anders is. Anders in Kaapstad. A story of a city that aims for unity instead of division. Eenheid eerder as verdeeldheid. Wat groter droom. Wat meer dinge gedoen kry as enige ander stad in ons land. But the last few years, the last 15 years in particular of our story's history, shows us that these things don't happen on their own. Dis nie net outomaties nie. Dit vat harde werk. Dit vat effort om in te sit. En dis wat die DA hier gedoen het. The best moments of unity and victory and progress for our city do not happen by themselves. They require some force, 'n mag, 'n gees om dit vorentoe te dryf. When we look around our country now, we know that no one else is going to fix it. Dit gaan ons wees. Dit moet ons wees wat dit regmaak. Do you know that in Kaapstad vandag, dames en here, daar is meer as 'n miljoen mense wat net 'n paar jaar gelede die trein gebruik het elke dag vir werk, wat nie meer vandag die trein kan gebruik nie. Dis 'n absolute skande, 'n tragedie. We've lost 64% of Cape Town's rail system. The same is true for policing. Becky Tselle het 551 polisiebeampte weggevat van Kaapstad af. Kan jy dit glo? John sê, hou jou Becky. We have stepped into the gap there, as John spoke about our LEAP project. But nothing more illustrates what's happening in South Africa today than the fact that these lights in this hall is nie aan nie. Right now, as we are standing here now, this hall, this neighborhood is under load shedding. The only reason the sound system is working and these lights are working is because we've got a generator at the back that the DA has organized. Even in this hall, the DA is keeping the lights on. You know that costs us 500 million rand a day for our economy. And yesterday, jy sal dit nie glo nie. Yesterday, the president of our country, President Ramaphosa, says to the country, we're only going to get the lights back on if you vote ANC. Someone has to explain that to me. Here in the Western Cape, we don't understand. That's higher grade logic. Because sê vir jy het die huis aan die brand gesteek. Jy het die hele huis aan die brand gesteek en nou vra jy nog tyd om die brand uit te sit. Iemand moet dit vir my verduidelik. We've got so many lekker Weskaap woorde. I would like to use one now. My God, ek gaan nie. You know, on Wednesday, I was with Ricardo in Gawa, in Mitchell's Plain, in Lentegia. And we met this young man, Ricardo, who is writing matric exams right now. He's writing matric exams. The next day, he was writing business studies when we visited him. And he was sleeping through load shedding so that he could wake up at midnight and start studying when the lights are on. And he's writing an exam the next morning. That's what's happening in our country because of load shedding. Other times he's forced to study for his matric exams with a little candle. Young people like him are being robbed of the opportunities that they need to live a better life in our city and in our country. But friends, we know in the DA that it does not have to be this way. We will not let Cape Town live in the dark ages with no electricity, broken trains, and a failing police service. Dit begin op Maandag. On Monday, we have the chance to pick up our pens in that voting booth and start writing the new chapter for Kaapstad. That's what we got to do. And I already know what the name of that chapter is going to be. I know what the name of that chapter is going to be. That chapter is going to be called When Cape Town Did More Than Ever Before to Look After Its Residents and Secure Its Future. That's what that chapter is going to be called. Because that's what Cape Town deserves. We know here that at the southern tip of Africa is a city that under the DA will shine a light of pride and optimism for our whole country and our whole continent. This will be a city where every one of you kan trotsheidvol en hoopvol in die toekoms onder die DA, where you know that you will be able to provide a better life for your families. That's what it's about. Dat jy kan sorg vir your family, for your kinders, where our children can grow up feeling safety in the streets and with access to opportunities that they need to build a better lives than the ones we live today. Kaapstad, my blow family, I'm here today to tell you all of this is possible because of the DA. That's why it's possible. A vote for the DA on Monday is a vote to ensure that our city does more than ever before. To end load shedding in Cape Town over time. Is julle sick and sat for load shedding? Okay, maybe we must stop that pledge because it doesn't sound like you're that irritated by it. Is julle sick and sat for load shedding? A plan to improve safety in every one of our communities by pulling down control of police, not in Pretoria, 15,000 kilometers away, Vatugal, maar hier in Kaapstad, die beheer van die SAPS. We're going to kick down those doors and push out those boundaries so that we can look after Cape Town even better. Already, Alan and Bertie and Dan have rolled out 1,000 law enforcement officers in the city to make up for how your Becky's a failure. They've rolled it out. We're keeping people safer because the DA is doing more. We're already doing that. And we're going to continue to invest in that program and roll it out more and make communities feel safer. So my message to Becky Tele is jammer vir jou. Staan soontoe. Whether you like it or not, we're going to fix what you've broken in Cape Town. We're going to make our community safer. We're going to roll out more law enforcement officers. And there's nothing you can do about it. There's nothing you can do about it, Becky. Because that's the mandate that we have from voters to look after our communities. So try as you might, Cape Town will do more. Just like electricity, just like policing, we need a functioning public transport system. We cannot have 1 million people who can't get to work every day because the trains are broken. You know that last week, Transnet lost 13 kilometers of copper cable. In a week, is it weg? Our entire citywide rail infrastructure is disappearing before our eyes. So we're going to have to take the fight to national government to get control over our passenger rail system so that we can partner with the private sector to start turning this around. And we're not just going to wait for rail. We are also going to roll out our own public transport system by expanding the My City Bus system. And here's a commitment. We will get the N2 expressway back up and running quickly. Because it's a vital artery in our city's economy. It must run. Ending load shedding, expanding law enforcement powers, taking police powers, fighting for control over our trains, and expanding our own bus network. These are examples of what we mean when we say or people are Carter, let's do more. And we're not going to stop there. We're going to make Cape Town a place where it's easier for you to get a job. Actually, everything that we do is about this. Everything that we do. When we talk about load shedding, it's not just about the matriculant who needs to write his paper. It's about helping people get jobs. You know that as we sit here right now, mense verloor werk. Mense verloor werk because of this load shedding. So when we talk about policing, it's about keeping you safe so that you can get to work. And it's about keeping businesses safe so that they can grow. When we talk about public transport, when we talk about making this place an easier place to do business, alles gaan oor werk, ekonomiese groei. Because we want more people out of poverty and in jobs. So to the youth in our communities, 7 out of 10 cannot find a job in South Africa. Can you believe that? 7 out of 10. Dis nie volhoubaar nie. So I hope that in me as a young mayor, you can see an ally and a friend who's going to work day and night with our provincial government, with our city government, with our teams to make sure that you as young people can get an opportunity in this economy. Kom ek sê ook, dit gaan oor basiese dienste. As ons praat van meer doen, praat ons ook van basiese dienste. Because that's what dignity means. If we want every person in our city to live a life of dignity, they've got to have access to better basic services. It's time for us to take pride in our city, to help our communities clean up our streets, our dumping sites, and our waterways. Let's take pride in Cape Town. We want it to be easier to work in Cape Town, cleaner to work in Cape Town, and more proud to work in Cape Town. And you've heard me speak a lot in this election about our housing shortage in Cape Town. I'm so proud. I spent time with Bev in this ward and she took me through some of the plans. Who feel was it, Bev? 1,500 new City of Cape Town built units coming in this ward alone. Dis 'n goeie storie. Dis wat ons bedoel. We're gonna release more city-owned land, like the land that Bev showed me here in her ward, for faster, more affordable housing for more Capetonians. So that's what we mean when we say die DR familie is gereed om meer te doen in Kaapstad. We are gonna write a new chapter of Cape Town's story. We are always at our strongest as Capetonians when we reject division and when we work together in unity and love. No matter our background, Cape Town is our home. Hierdie is ons huis. Ons is lief vir hierdie stad. Ons wil dit sien werk en meer doen en beter doen. Dis hoekom ons noem dit die moederstad. So this is personal. So when you pick up your pen on Monday, ons blou familie, when you pick up your pen, get ready to write a new story for Cape Town. More services, more housing, more electricity, more trains, more policing, less ANC, less unemployment, less corruption, Less crime in our communities. Dis hoekom ons sê Kaapstad werk. Now let's do more. Kaapstad werk. Now let's Kaapstad werk. Now let's
more.
Dankie. Kom ons gaan stem. Kom ons gaan wen op Maandag.
GHL.
GHL. GHL. GHL. GHL. GHL. GHL. GHL. GHL.
Imagine a South Africa without the Democratic Alliance and the EFF as the official opposition. Expropriation without compensation will be law, and corruption and chaos will destroy what's left. Only the DA is big enough to stop the ANC and EFF. We have proven that where we govern, we get things done. But a vote for a smaller party only weakens the DA. Let's not play with fire. Vote DA.